Hello gang, what's up? So welcome to my vlog. So today I want to talk about three topics in endurance. First is the conformation of horse in endurance. Second is I want to talk about veterinary inspection. And the last one is metabolic and soundness. So today I'm at the faculty, so I want to discuss with my member about the three topics about endurance. Okay, so they already arrived, so they are in the class. So hi, sorry I'm late.
Yeah, but
MJ say hi.
Hi.
Nas say hi.
Hi.
Chung say hi.
Hi.
And the last one. Okay.
Hi, my name is Yameche, and today I will lead the discussion about the endurance. So the first topic is about vet inspection. So Longman, please go ahead.
Hello. So the first topic yang kita akan bincang adalah tentang vet inspection. So vet inspection dalam endurance ni terletak di kawasan vet gate dan trotting area. So, vet inspection ni berlaku selepas water cooling station, dan akan pergi kuda tersebut akan pergi ke vet gate dan melalui proses vet inspection. So, dalam vet inspection, kita ada beberapa aspek yang vet tersebut akan check pada kuda, iaitu heart rate, skin recoil, CRT iaitu capillary refill time, mucous membrane, muscle tone, gut sound and gait. So, macam mana kita nak tengok gait kuda tu? Sama ada gait tu normal ataupun tidak. So, dengan adanya trotting area, kita vet akan mampu untuk melihat sama ada gait tu normal ataupun tidak. Sekiranya kuda tu mempunyai gait yang agak tidak normal, vet akan membuat keputusan ataupun memberitahu yang kuda tersebut akan disqualify. Jikalau kuda itu tersebut mempunyai gait normal, dia akan meneruskan loop yang seterusnya. So, itu untuk vet inspection.
So, the next discussion is about the conformation of horse in endurance. So, Emily, please explain.
Okay. For the good conformation of horse, the first one is willing, eager and calm. And the second is the horse should have a strong frame. Third is good movement. And the last one is size of horse. Firstly is willing, eager and calm. So riders should choose an ideal horses to such as the horse love to run and competitive, so that the rider also can continue to control the horse. And rider cannot to choose some lazy horse because they cannot use spur or whipping, that is forbidden in the competition. Second is a strong frame. A good leg conformation of horse can withstand stress than imperfect leg is a good movement. For a ideal horse, they have a good movement so that they can have a long reaching trot and a smooth comfortable canter. The last one is size of horse. 14.2 to 15.2 hands is preferred ideal horse. And large horse and muscular horse, they will take longer time to lose the body heat. So actually, it's not so preferred to use a large horse. And because if overheating, they will easily get the metabolic problem.
So thank you, Emily. So next we will proceed to Chung, Cecilia Chung, for the explanation in metabolic.
Okay, metabolic disorder seems to be the major contributory factor in elimination of horses from endurance races. So next, metabolic disorders seems to metabolic disorders can be include signs of high heart rate, dehydration, decreased gut motility, and congested mucous membrane refill time.
So tadi dapat arahan untuk kita guna kelas ni untuk ditutup. So kita kena pindah ke tempat lain. So
okay, I want to say a bit about the heart rate. The normal heart rate is 32 until 48 beats per minute, which is if it is higher than that, it called high heart rate. So it causes metabolic disorders. And next is dehydration. Dehydration, we can see the eyes of the horse is sunken. So it's sunken eyes. And then skin sugar increase and dry, sticky mucous membrane. Last but not least, in metabolic also, they check about the temperature of the horse, which is the normal temperature of the horse is 37.2 degrees Celsius until 38.3 degrees Celsius. If it is higher than that, it also causes metabolic disorders. So that's all about metabolic.
So thank you, Cecilia. So next we'll proceed to Nazura to explain us about the soundness in endurance.
Okay, for the soundness of the horse in the endurance, the horse must in healthy horse, like we can see in their withers, back and girth, and then muscle tone and gait. After that, make sure the horse is in healthy horse. That means the horse is not in unsoundness. The example of unsound horse is lameness and have a colic.
Okay, so that's all from our discussion. Thank you. Hope you enjoy.
Bye.